guys. Welcome back. It's 1987 Mastermind. What's going on, everybody? And in this part, we are going to... Yeah, it's great to be back, and in this part, we will fly through and hit one of the Titans, and get to the path to Labyrinth, part one, because you'll see later. But anyways, guys, it's a pleasure to be back, and this part is a biatch, because there's so many tight corridors and tight areas and holes and stuff like that you have to be aware of. My advice is, this part's heavy. That's what really brings. That's why this game is so freaking realistic. And all the games tell us, man. This is what, you know, brings God of War to be more epic than all the other games. Like I said in the last video, I hope you enjoyed that part of the video where I did some, cool stuff. And I'm sorry I died. I really didn't want that to happen, but that part is a biatch. Yeah, it really is tough. And here on Epic Fail 2, I die a couple of times. This is post-commentary. I have to do it like this. I love to do live commentary. But as of now, I mean, Sith mentioned this. Whoever knows dark-minded Sith, that audacity tends to crash. And it does that a lot. I mean, like, whenever I try to record live, it always messes me up, And also, guys, I mean, I don't have that many subscribers, but whoever is interested, really wants to be able to be a good Alpira, you should definitely check out, Dark Minded Sith did a couple of videos giving advice, and I just want to personally, in the public air, thank Dark Minded Sith for those videos. It really helped me out, because, it gives me ideas of how to be, just try to make pretend you're playing with your one of the advice he gave was try to be relaxed, make pretend you're playing with your friends. That's what I try to do with these videos. Ah, man, you wouldn't want to hear me while I was playing this, because I was cursing out the screen. Because I died two or three times unnecessarily, very, very careless, and, just gonna warn you, we stopped abruptly at, an important part of the video, but I couldn't, the 15-minute time limit. I wish I had more than 15 minutes, because I would have finished. So it does suck, but those are the rules of YouTube. What are you gonna do? Well, there's another Alpira out there. I won't mention his name. I don't know him that well. That I saw. He had like 30-minute videos. I'm like, what the hell? How did he do that? Yeah, I don't know. But anyway, this part, I have no real advice. Just you have to, this is one of those things you have to figure it out on your own. You just essentially got to be aware. There's gonna be a lot of tight spots where there's a lot of like wood and stuff. You just have to be aware. You have to be very, very alert. Very, very. Just make sure your reflexes are good, because you're gonna have to be very fast. And don't be surprised, don't get discouraged or disparaged. You are gonna die a couple of times on this part. I'm just telling you that much, because this part is hell. It's fun, don't get me wrong. I mean, here I die, I understand, but I couldn't see the platform. God. I know you guys are gonna think, man, Mastermind, you suck. But, that's one of the weaknesses, I believe, of God of War 3, is that the platform is a little bit annoying. That double jump. Like, I used to have so much problems with that, you see? Oh, man, you guys are probably... Anyway. So, I'm glad to be back, and I hope to be up when we're off, and school's over.
Yeah, baby! No more school!
And you know what that is. It means... We don't need no education. That's right, no more education, baby. Well, at least for the next couple of weeks, because of the holidays, like Christmas and New Year's. That's now Hanukkah, For those like me who celebrate Hanukkah. Yeah. You know. I hope everybody's enjoying their holiday. You guys want to comment below what you got on Black Friday? I'm just curious, because I never shop on Black Friday. No way. I mean, if anybody... I'm sorry I'm going off like this. Some of you want to hear about the game, but, you know, there's nothing really happening. So you just got to be aware. There's nothing real, no real advice. I would suggest using... Just jumping to the side using your X button. This is a God of War 3 game, so I don't have to tell you about it. Just jump, do a quick jump, which I didn't do there. But I end up figuring this out, so it's good. We make a lot of progress in this video. Yeah, so I hope to be, like I said, uploading every day or every other day, so look for a video tomorrow. I shouldn't be any problem. I don't know what's school tomorrow. Maybe in the morning I might do, but I don't have school in the morning, so we'll see. I can't wait to finish this LP, because I have tons of them. I just want to... I told you guys before in my update videos, but I have tons of plans for the next LP. And it's going to be one that I know better. I mean, I beat this game twice, but, you know, still, it's a game to beat. This is a fairly difficult game. We're not going to have the music fly like an eagle, but I'll do it. Fly like an eagle! No. But I hope you guys enjoyed that part. I mean, I thought that was an amazing idea. Just fly like an eagle. You know, the blades of the goes so well, in my opinion. So, I'm going to put that in. It's already recorded. I did it successfully. I saved it. So, I hope you guys enjoyed. See, here you just got to be very careful of the wood and all that stuff that's tightly close together. And you just got to be very alert. You got to have crazy reflexes. This is very difficult. It's a small little hole you have to get through. And sometimes, like when I first played this part, you don't see it. You just have very keen sight, very quick reflexes on this part. And if you don't, you're going to die a couple of times. But it's really not that difficult. It's like with any other video game. Once you see it more than once, you'll anticipate where everything is going to be. So it really gets easier after a while. And we did it. So now, this is Labyrinth. This place, I'm not going to say why, for those who haven't played this game yet and are considering to buy this game, which I don't know why you wouldn't have bought this sooner, but whatever. Maybe it's because you don't have money, but I call it the Caverns, but this is Labyrinth. This is Labyrinth Part 1. You'll see why this place is very relevant later. Okay. All right, so this part's extremely tough. I died once, but yeah, I stopped very abruptly in this part. I'm really sorry, but... yeah, so first here, obviously, you see that you gotta use your blades. Okay, bow. Get rid of that. See, this part is very hard, because the camera zooms all the way out, and it's hard to see the craters, so it's very hard to do it. You know, but... Yeah, but, you know. Anyway. Yeah. Mastermind's running out of things to say. Better think quick. Anyways, but one thing I'll tell you that I've noticed, about doing this. Sorry about the color, dude. I was trying to fix the color to make it brighter. Some LP here out there. One LP here, I'll definitely mention him. He's subscribed to me. He's a great guy. Really, one of the nicest people. I mean, really nice guy. He leaves a lot of nice and kind comments. Step 54503. Check out his channel, by the way. He's a really good guy. Seriously, he's doing an LP of Zelda. And he's doing an LP of Kingdom Hearts 2. So, definitely should check him out. Try to do that so, you know, not to get subscribers, but to just appreciate other people, you know, because, you know, they're the people watching the videos, and you gotta try to appeal to them. I'm not just doing this for me, and the reason why I love doing these videos. So, here's pretty simple. You just hold R1 and you swing. It's a typical thing in a video game. Alright, so this part is gonna be those two boxes. The one with the axe. They're gonna try to break the box, the metal part of the box. So you have to essentially kill them before they take it off and you fall. And die. And fall. Basically. So, just. You know, my suggestion is that same move on the same move on those other bad guys. R1 circle one should be okay. I did die once, but I did make progress. And see, I just had to stop abruptly because that was a 15-minute one. I wish that YouTube had longer, you know, timer. I wish it was longer. It's like a 20-minute one. But the thing you essentially have to do again, like I said, I would suggest using R1 in the circle. That really use against those other bad guys. That usually stops them. Once you let them get away, you see? They're going to try to break that. They break it before. If they break it, they hit it enough times, it'll fall apart, down, and you're dead. So basically, you've got to hit them before they get a chance to hit the metal part, the metal hatch, hinge. Very, very careful. And you always got to be alert and make sure they don't even get a chance to hit it because, like there, you see? If you see that, just try to hit him. Make sure he doesn't, obviously break it. And that's all the advice I can give you. I would suggest any bad guy part, try not to get the magic, like I just did. Oh, what am I doing? Alright, use magic earlier. Try not to use your, I forgot what it's called. It's called Blades of the Wrath of Athens, or something like that. Correct me in the comments. It's like your, try not to use, yeah, your Blade of Olympus, actually, I should say. Try not to use your Blade of Olympus, because you want to save that for the end when it's almost finished and you have no health left and it's almost time to finish. So be very careful. I think that's the key in any video game, is to use your magic very wisely. Because that is something you need only in desperate situations. Like, if you, play this game enough time, you should be able to. Maybe you should box it. I'm pretty surprised. We do make a lot of progress this season, thank God. Thank the Lord! Praise the Lord! Alright. I don't want to go too crazy. These gotta be, this and the those other bad guys that go onto the platform. It's gotta be one of the most annoying bad guys in the video game. I hate these guys. They're such a piss off. Oh, God, they're so annoying. But, once you get used to them, it shouldn't be that bad. Yeah. Sorry if I sound a little bit out of it. I have a long day today. Work, college. School's open, though, I tell you. Gotta look on the right side, right? Yeah. It's always a very thing aspect of the video. Another thing I'd like to comment is I like the way the firemen moves in the background. Most video games, you don't find that much. Like, everything has a purpose in the background. It really brings this game to life. Everything in the background is so detailed, so refined. And it's not just there for show. You know what I mean? Most of the game, it's there because...
father walked in.
Now everybody on YouTube gets to hear that, Daddy. Sorry, father walked in. Ah, he's cool. He's good. Alright, so I'm sorry I have to stop this video so soon. Well, that's another good idea. I would try that too. If you really don't want to fight those guys and you just want to piss off, try to get them off the... try to throw them off the edge so you don't have to worry about them. You'll be okay. Sorry I stopped a couple times. Just a few minutes. Anyway. So we're gonna stop right here. Anyway. Always decides to do the walking at the wrong time. This is up to you. Sorry about that, guys. I thought that one happened. That's why it's very hard to record. When your father walks in, it's disruptive, and I live with other people, yes. That easy to do. Yeah. Anyway. Alright, guys. Take care. See you next video.